So today we're going to talk about a very difficult topic, that is meditation, because I consider people usually call meditation a very difficult topic. Okay, even I have talked to a lot of people, they have tried meditation, they are doing meditation, they call that, okay, meditation is very difficult. And even I've tried meditation for a long time, it is not that easy, that anyone can easily at one time can get habituated of that, can do it very easily. It is little bit difficult. So today our podcast will be all about meditation. Okay, we'll be talking about how meditation changed your life, what are the importance of meditation, why we should do meditation. So without any further ado, okay, let us get started. So Mr. AP, my first question is that, okay, as you are connected to meditation from many years, as you have told me, so can you tell me some of the changes what you have got from doing meditation, like what you were before and what you are now? Okay, after doing meditation, what you were before, okay, when you were not doing meditation, and what you are now, okay, how you can see, what changes you can see in yourself after doing meditation. Can you explain to me something about that, about your journey of your meditation?
Yeah, absolutely. I would love to share my journey with you. And the changes in me are immense. If we sit down and if we just start talking about only the changes that I have felt and I have, you know, gone through because of meditation, then I think the limit of this podcast, the time limit will be exhausted. So I'll just tell you the major changes that I have gone through. Earlier in my teenage, I was a very rude, rebellious, and a typical boy, typical college going boy. And because, you know, I grew fast, I grew 6 feet tall. And I had a very good build. So there was this ego, there was this reality distortion that I was living in, that I am supreme, that I am the best. I was not, but I was. So I started disobeying everything. So I was like a rebellious kid, any rebellious kid. But that rebelliousness was harming me, and I wasn't able to see it because I lacked clarity. I was so delusioned by the reality that I had created for myself, that, you know, that I wasn't able to see what the future, how my current activities were affecting my future. And this is something that I think every teenager, every Indian boy goes through, because we all want to be respected. We all want to, you know, to be loved. We all want to be cherished. We all want to be celebrated, because in India, the celebrity culture is very large. So every small town boy has this dream of being celebrated, has this dream of, you know, famous, being famous. That, and because of this dream, you know, Bollywood industry is still surviving. It's just because of this dream, right? So I was a typical same boy. But, you know, then I started meditating. About meditation, I have also shared this on my Instagram page in one of my IGTVs. I started meditation when I was 10 years old. So, like, meditation has been throughout, like, if I look back now, meditation has been there throughout my life. Like, since I got a consciousness about things. I was the one who wasn't accepting meditation. I was running away, right? But then, I started meditating because of my father. My father pushed me into meditation, and I was like, okay, let's try it. You know, I have what to lose. Then I started liking that practice. Because of that practice, firstly, I felt that, you know, the stress, the amount of stress that I used to get from school and everything was lessening. And was going down and down, and it was decreasing. The second change was that I was also into practices, you know, I was also into practices of consuming alcohol and smoking. So that also changed. It happened in such a fashion that, you know, at first I used to enjoy those activities. When I started meditating, I was doing those activities, but the enjoyment from those activities that I used to get started decreasing. So if naturally, naturally one day I was like, yeah, I don't get, you know, I don't want to. This doesn't please me anymore, these practices. Mm-hmm. So that happened. Right. So that was the second major change. The third major change was my mentality got evolved. Right. I was open-minded from starting. There was no problem, but my perspective changed around the world. So, you know, if you're someone who finds it difficult, if anyone's watching, if you're someone who finds it difficult to understand what is going around you, then meditation can actually help you give a third person's perspective. So sometimes, you know, things happen like we think we are right and the next person also thinks we are right. So if both people think that they are right in their own perspective, then there's a problem. So if so in that situation, you need a third perspective to, you know, tell you, you know, you are wrong and you are right. But what happens when you don't have the third perspective? So meditation gives you that third perspective. It actually, and it does that by promoting higher intelligence. So basically, you know, there is this voice in your head that tells you sometimes, you know, you shouldn't do this or you should do that. That which we call intuition, gut feeling. Meditation increases that. So basically, you get a third person in your head. You basically get a parent in your head who's always guiding you, who's always telling you, okay, dude, this is bad, this is good. You should do this. You should not do this. And, you know, everything that comes with it is immense, right? Mm-hmm. And, you know, the general benefits of meditation are also there. Like, it's calming. It helps me, you know, it helps me be humble, grateful. It helps me also to cope with my goals and targets. Mm-hmm. Because, see, in life, failures are bound to happen. Every person in this life, no matter if you're a topper in the school, you will fail in life. No matter you won't fail in academics, but in some other part of your life, you will exactly fail. So meditation also teaches you to how to accept failure and then work towards it and use that failure as experience and, you know, work towards your success again. So that is something that also meditation has given you. Because, and trust me, Rishabh, I fail every day, right? I write down tasks on my board that I have to do these tasks, but something or some other thing happens, right? And those things aren't bad, right? Those things are also good that happen. But I'm not able to complete the task that I said to myself that I will do it. Now, I have two options. Either I can, you know, sit and worry about it or, you know, feel guilty about it, that, or either I can start again. It's like, okay, I'll try and do it again. So this philosophy of doing it again and again and again, you know, persistence, meditation promotes persistence in a person. So I think I have become more persistent because with my page, my Instagram page and content creation, this page is my third or fourth venture into content creation. Before this, I was making tech videos, vlogs, you know, product reviews, fashion tips, grooming tips and everything, fitness videos. So I have been creating content for a long time, but, you know, something happened to us, some channels went up, but, you know, due to exams and everything, wasn't able to cope up with that. So many things have happened and which has resulted in, you know, not those channels not succeeding. But again, I am persistent enough to again start with something new.
Exactly.
Right. So this is something that has meditation changed. Because if before meditation, if I were to fail, I would have left it. I would have said, "This is." I would do something else, but I won't do this. But because I am persistent enough, this persistence has only, has only grown in me because of the practice of meditation. And I seriously feel that there is no end to changes that a person can experience with meditation. With each 10 or 20 minutes that you practice meditation, you change. Something in you changes. Like you might not be able to notice it, but something in you changes. So every time you meditate, things happen and things change in you. So to say that, you know, to conclude that, you know, things, what changes have meditation, you know, brought in me, I wouldn't be able to answer it fairly. But I have tried to, you know, with context to the problems that my generation, my people and children and teenagers face, I have put it in that way because I have also gone through it and meditation has pulled me out through them. So yeah, these were the changes that actually happened because of meditation to me.
Okay. Got it. Yeah, thank you so much for explaining the things again. And you have said the things in a very right, okay? You have explained the thing. Okay, because like you can say that meditation has completely changed you from a different person to different person, okay? As you have said that you were having some bad addiction and different kind of things, okay? But after doing meditation, you can see a lot of changes in yourself, okay? So that is great. So you can say that meditation was a life-changing experience for you, okay? It has really changed your life, really changed your way of thinking and way of living.